Hey, welcome back to our Baldur's Gate 3 single-player playthrough on our character Melisandre, the Tiefling Warlock. We are going to be picking back up where we left off, we just finished clearing out the Goblin Camp, rescuing Helsan. Cleared out like a secret area inside the Goblin Camp that had like a way to the Underdark. We're actually going to go fight a spider boss that we found the other day in the Blighted Town. And I believe that also has another way to the Underdark. So yeah, that's what we're planning on doing. We're trying to get level 5. We are very close to level 5. I appreciate you guys sticking along. Once we get level 5, we'll probably go fight the hag. So yeah, thank you. Sorry about that. I do my intro really fast. I'm so close to being affiliate on Twitch. I'm like at 3.57 average views per month. I gotta keep it at 3.
I just watch that video you sent to me.
It's fucking nuts, isn't it?
He can push off the edge.
Homie got yeeted off the edge. And the funny thing about it is you can do that with spells as well as physical force. So, like, there's spells called, like, Thunder Wave and whatever. You can launch them off the edge.
I'm having a hard time believing they're a coincidence. Still, there may be more to it. I need to keep alert, in case that suspicion amounts to anything.
That's fair enough.
Don't deceive me.
Quite cruelly, too.
Apart from an overgrowth of moss, the well looks unremarkable. Dry stones line the wall. At the bottom, something gleams in the dappled light.
Best not touch those webs or I'll end up as a meal.
Not know this place was over here last time. Okay. Found a new place. I've got almost 90 hours in this game and I keep finding new shit. In the first area too, which is fucking nuts.
Better not be cursed.
Oh my god, TJ, there was this really hilarious book that we found yesterday. And it was basically just a book for goblins and other monsters and how to play basically drinking games. So one of them was like, hey, try to throw an eyeball into a flagon, which is beer pong. And then if you fail, first one has to go raid a village. Just some dumb shit like that. Like, even the books are hilarious. That's fucked up.
What's in here?
do we do everybody? Pressing Shift C should make everybody go into stealth. Okay. So Shift C. Oh. There you go. Now everybody's sneaking. Alright, cool. We can go over here, okay.
Should mind my step.
So I'll go over here. Did I miss? Oh my god, I missed. What dog water?
I speak, they burn.
Torment.
Come after me.
Who's got more health this thing? That thing's got 33 health. Get all the way out there on foot. No, she can't get all the way there on foot. Okay. Let's go as far as we can. Stop hitting my squishy wizard. Oh my god.
Thank you.
take two humans.
Fuck yes.
So let's go. Oh, balls. Utter sadness. What do you mean not enough movement speed, bro? Oh, that guy's still alive, lol.
I'll be right back, Joshua.
Thanks.
Let's get going.
Patched up. Pushing on.
Time to get going.
Thank you. Ow.
Got it.
Did you convince Levi to get it yet?
He hasn't been on to me to try to convince him to get it. He did ask if you were gonna get it.
I haven't seen him for a while. Or I haven't seen him for a while.
Where the fuck are her potions at? Oh, she doesn't have any. Damn it. Oh, that's my fault. Thank you. Level 5! Promoted!
Lost in thought.
Oh my lord.
My face protects what? Me.
What's wrong, buddy?
I just this map or this boss is just kind of a pain in the butt. My lord. Blah la 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 la.
Blah la 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 la.
Blah la 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 la.
Thank you.
beat him.
Hmm. That's fantastic. Okay, cool.
Let's have a peek inside. Something ominous about such depths. Wonder how deep it goes.
Well, after you.
Would you like to long rest? Yes, please. Yes, please, master.
Thank you.
gotta go night night. There's one slightly annoying mechanic in regards to the fact that you have to gather like food and stuff like that for full night's rest.
Gather what?
You have to gather food and stuff for like full night's rests.
I promised I'd.
But it's
back.
Okay. You get a decent amount of it. It just Don't fills worry. Up your inventory really bad.
I have things under control. For now. I see you've been using the powers the tadpole gives you. Good. But things haven't gone as you expected. You hoped a druid as powerful as Halsin might be able to remove your tadpole. But he couldn't. You're desperate to be rid of it. Understandable. But you're looking for solutions in the wrong places. Yes. Halsin is correct. Your parasite is unusual. It is wrapped in magic that prevents its removal. Until the source of the tadpole's magic is destroyed, any attempt to remove it will kill you. You were lucky that Halsin knew this. His instincts are right. The parasites are merely a symptom of a greater sickness in Faerun. I have kept a careful watch on the movements of the cult. Though the Absolute's aims are not yet clear to me, its methods are. These parasites are more than illicit spawn. They are vessels for control. The infected hear the voice of the Absolute and believe it to be a god. That is how the cult of the Absolute is spreading. The highest of their rank, the True Souls, carry a tadpole just like yours. It is how they receive their orders. It is what makes them obey. When the order to transform is given, it will not be a matter of days. They will be mind flayers in an instant. Were it not for my protection, so would you. I have powers of my own. Unique powers. But know that we are alike. Just like you, I was infected with a mind flayer parasite. Just like you, I seek to be free of it. I've been trying to escape from this evil for a long time. Once, I almost succeeded. Now, through you, I've been given a new chance. You can go where I cannot, and I can protect you from that evil. If we work together, we may turn this around. Hells, they need me. I have to go. No. I can handle this. For now. The power I used to protect you, I stole it from someone. They want it back. I will hold them off for as long as I can, but sooner or later, I will be worn down. You must discover the source of the magic that controls the parasites before that happens. The cultists are gathering at Moonrise Towers. Use the powers your parasite gives you to convince them you are one of them. And when you find the source of their magic, destroy it. Go. Our freedom depends on it.
Okay.
Be on my way.
Is this place?
Don't look. Don't.
Stop. Please. Please.
Away. Away.
How did they know?
Dulo! put them on. I've got it.
Let's light them up.
In for a surprise?
Soldier.
You can't see me.
Still alive, so that's progress.
Hmm.
can't afford to stay idle.
I mean, I wish he had Gust. Okay.
Wanna dance?
This'll be fun.
Lovely day this, for now. Nasty surprise. Caution is warranted here.
Avoid that trap. This way.
Yikes.
Looking ahead.
What am I to do? I am ready.
There's a trap.
Careful where you tread here. A hag's magic is not to be trifled with.
Hmm.
prime spot for an app.
There, in the cage.
Enough! Don't do this!
Oh.
Stop it! All of you!
That's aggravating.
One day, I'll catch a break.
Thank you.
spectacle.
Hello? Select her as one of the targets, please. We gave you these for a reason, Gale. Let's use them, buddy.
Thank you.
Wait! Oh, wait just a tick!
Killing me is a waste of time. I'll find a way to return. Always have, always will. But it's unpleasant. So how about we be civilized about this, I have something you want.
I knew I liked you, dearie. Let me leave with the girl, and I'll give you power. You want to be stronger, tougher, smarter? Done. Anything is possible.
Just let me keep the girl and her babe.
Please. She's dreaming if she thinks we'd leave Mayrina here.
It's your choice, sweetness.
TJ?
Yeah?
Do I let some old fucking witch keep this girl and her child? Or do I kill the old fucking witch? Or maybe kill the old fucking witch? And we see what happens. She's offering me power. She said, I don't know. She said, I'll give you power. I'll give you anything that you want. And she said, if you kill me, I'll just find a way to come back. I always have and I always will.
I mean, hoes are temporary. Especially ones with kids. Power is forever.
That is pretty accurate.
Situations like these where I'm like, what would Levi do?
I can try to intimidate her and take the power and the girl.
I bet she has some kind of stupid, like, intimidation factor, though.
Yeah, I have to pass an intimidation check or a deception check, depending on what choice I make. One second. I'm going to use the bathroom while I'm thinking about this.
Thank you.
Alright. Let me figure out what we want to do. Let's see here. Let's drop a save. We'll drop a save and we'll see what happens.
Greedy little ballocks. Fine. Here. I'll not soon forget this sweetness. You have my word.
But the deal. What about my husband? What happens to him?
Deal's off, you dumb cow. And you've him to thank for it. Not that it matters. I'll find another just as plump and ripe. I can set up shop elsewhere. People always need lotions and potions.
Oh my gosh, yes, yes, Josh. I'll play Baldur's Gate with you. You don't have to keep begging. What's up, buddy? How was your day?
Bro, I'm so over today.
Yeah, was it a rough day for you? Luck.
It's only the oh, well, it's because of everything that happened. One second, though. Okay.
You
okay.
Bastard! You ruined it! You ruined everything! Go on. Walk away. And wave to my husband's rotting corpse on your way out. That's right. He's buried outside, and I was this close to getting him back. Thanks to you, I'll never see him again.
That sounds like your problem, yo. Anyway, so basically, I guess a update got pushed through, a quick fix got pushed through, and it caused my save file to get corrupted, and I couldn't play on any of the saves that I had.
So all the saves are fucked?
Well, no, I had to submit a ticket to Larian Studios to get them to get my save files back. So, I got them back now. I had to uninstall and reinstall the game and get all my save file, or like get a ticket in with them to get my save files back. So, it was ridiculous.
At least we were big smart. That was like one of the first things we said was it was maybe a quick fix. Went through and just fucked everything.
Yeah. I just rescued that's my character's name. I rescued that
Mithyarna.
Girl. Yeah, whatever her name, from Auntie Ethel. And bro, she is big pissed.
Pissed that you saved her?
Yeah, because of the fact that she made a deal with the hag to get her husband back, to get him resurrected.
RIP.
Yeah.
For me.
I'm on my solo account at the moment. I'm still trying to convince TJ to get the game.
Well, have you fucking bought the game yet, TJ?
I'm not. Good here, I
hope. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, he can be wrong, trust me. He'll sit there and be wrong for a while. He'll do the same thing he did with Diablo. He'll not get the game, and then by the time that I've played it for literally 9 million hours, he'll get it. And then I'll still come crawling back to play with him like I always do. Ah, thank God.
So, TJ, do you just, like, hate good games? Or, like, what's up?
He doesn't want to play on his computer.
Skill just isn't a high enough level.
He He said it's because of the fact that his PC's upstairs and he doesn't want to have to go upstairs. Somebody wants to play in his room.
It's downstairs. Well, if this was on Xbox, I would have bought it day one.
It is coming out on Xbox, but we don't know. We don't have a release date yet, and we don't know if it's going to be crossplay.
Move your PC downstairs, plug it up to a TV, and connect your controller to it.
Gods,
the game's on PlayStation. It's got controller support.
I know I should head home.
We're gonna have to move the PC upstairs.
The thought of putting him in the wheelbarrow.
Or you just leave it downstairs. Good.
But then I wouldn't.
Man,
have my
that's
nice
crazy. You don't know how to hook it all up. That's crazy. Yeah. You happen to be in a voice chat with two people that for a living over the phone tell people how to hook shit up. You know, we could be your guy.
Yeah.
Shake my head.
Uh-oh.
I'm here and he just hates good games.
Gosh dang it, dogs.
What? You can.
You feel a surge of power from the wand. The air suddenly tastes acrid. It wants to be used.
Bring it back. Bring Connor back. Please.
Feel something pull at you. The creature yearns for a master.
What have you done to him?
I tried to help. I didn't know it was gonna kill him. But to be fair,
forget it. The milk's already spilled.
To be fair, though, that's kind of how that normally would go. I wonder where she went.
Don't give me trouble now.
Oh my god, dogs. It can never be that easy. The wand? What the fuck? The wand is called Second Marriage, lol. Because it resurrects her husband back into a zombie. That's fucking golden. Goodness gracious.
I suppose they're ravenous predators with fangs like daggers. It's hardly an irrational fear to harbor. You've been decent to me so far. Maybe if you can, don't make me face any more of them. At least, not alone. Thank you. I had a feeling you'd be understanding.
have my attention.
What a charmer.
I've got a long road ahead.
Nice little nap.
for this.
Hey, for however long, I'm just gonna watch a little bit of TV with Lane, but if you decide that you want to hop over, just shoot me a text and I'll come hop over. I'm not really attached to what we're watching. No, you're good. Like I said, whenever you're ready, just shoot me a text.
Curiosity trumps combat, then.
Gods, it's hot in here.
Condition likes being ignored as little as I do. I must consume another artifact. And soon. Thank you.
Good gods. It hardly has any effect. Oh, Mistra, have mercy on us all. Listen, I need to speak to you, to all of you. It would be unconscionable of me to remain silent. I might just be about to remedy that. You have to know who I was. You have to know who I really am. What I am is a walking shadow of the promise I once held. I'm what one might call a wizard prodigy. And from an early age could not only control the weave, but compose it. Much like a musician or a poet. Such was my skill that it earned me the attention of the mother of magic herself. The Lady of Mysteries. The goddess Mistra. She revealed herself to me and she became my teacher. In time, she became my muse. And later, even my lover.
Oh, yes. We enjoyed each other's company. Body, mind, and soul. But even so, I desired more. You see, no matter how powerful a wizard we mortals can become, we never scratch more than the surface of the weave. Mistra keeps us in check. There are boundaries she doesn't let us cross. Yet, every time I was with her,
I stood on the precipice, gazing into the wonders that lay beyond. I sought to cross her boundaries. I tried to convince her. I pouted. I pleaded. Swore my ambition was only to serve her better. She only smiled and told me to be contented. Inconceivable as it seems to me now, I shared a bed with a goddess, and yet I wasn't satisfied. So I sought to prove myself worthy to her instead. We come now to the crux of my folly. Shall I share the story behind it, or would you rather head straight to its sordid finale? Very well. Here goes. Once upon a very long time ago, a mighty lord lived in a tower. A flying tower, to be precise. I'll save his history for another time, but the gist of it is that he sought to usurp the goddess of magic so that he could become a god himself. He almost managed, but not quite, and his entire empire, Netheril, came crashing down around him as he turned to stone. The magic that was unleashed that day was phenomenal. Roiling like the prime chaos that outdates creation. Even the weave itself could not withstand the onslaught. It fractured, then shattered, and all magic was lost to the mortal realms. Until the day Mistra returned. She restored the weave, reuniting all its scattered shards. Or so I thought. Until, in the course of my studies, I learned of a book. Netherese tome in which a piece of the fractured weave had been sealed beyond her reach. What if, I thought, what if, after all this time, I could return this lost part of herself to the goddess? answer was to try. And the outcome was to fail. I was certain that this deed of raw power, draped in romance, would convince Mistra to take me by the hand and welcome me into her hitherto forbidden domains. I was mistaken. I obtained the fabled book and took it into my study. As for what happened next... Here. Place your hand over my heart. Let me show you.
You feel the tadpole quiver as you realize Gale is letting you in. Into the dark. You see through Gale's eyes, staring down the corridors of a dread memory. A book bound and suddenly opened. Inside there are no pages, only a swirling mass of blackest weave that pulses. Its teeth, its claws, it's unstoppable as it digs through and becomes part of you. And gods, is it ever hungry.
Thankfully, the moment I absorbed the fragment wasn't enough to kill me outright. It was only the beginning. This Netherese blight, this orb, for lack of a better word, is balled up inside my chest. And it needs to be fed. As long as I absorb traces of the weave from potent enough sources, remains quiet. Were it ever to fully destabilize, however. I will erupt. I don't know the exact magnitude of the eruption, but given my studies of Netherese magic, I'd say even a fragment as small as the one I carry, it'd level a city the size of Waterdeep. We might chance upon a king's collection of magical artifacts around the corner. We might cross paths with a miracle round the bend. Then again, we might not. All of this, it must feel like a betrayal. Say the word, and we'll part ways.
If having dangerous otherworldly objects stuck in your skin is wrong, then Gale and I both have to go. We're not really splitting up, are we?
That is a great relief. Oh, a great relief indeed. You truly are a soul that steals my own. From all my new rallied heart, I thank you. I thank you all. I understand if you stand against me. I'm humbled if you stand with me. Either way, I will do my best not to let you down.
I stand at a precipice. But if you do not give up hope, neither shall I. I'll fight. I'll resist as long as I can. Now. Even I am tired of the sound of my own voice. Let us venture forth.
Come on!
I'm done. I can't wait to sleep.
Unusual runes are etched on the slate, forming an array of arcs and circles. You learn nothing from the slate.
Let's get on with it. No one stopped me yet. Try this way.
Unusual runes are etched on the slate, forming an array of arcs and circles. Magical energy courses through the slate. You are flooded with understanding.
A mystical map glows before you, revealing a Githyanki refuge within a temple at the mountain pass. This must be the crash that Lazelle seeks. The slate also reveals the Githyanki's purpose. They are combing the Sword Coast in search of a polyhedric relic of great importance to their queen.
Seems simple enough.
Hey, soldier. We've got a long way ahead of us, and there's something I want to tell you. But don't worry, it's nothing bad. Well, depending. Hear that? Infernal engine for a heart. Lets me burn as hot as the hells. Things been running in overdrive since I left Avernus. Won't be seeing my mechanic anytime soon, so I've been making the most of the extra heat. But it's meant I can't get too friendly. If I'm excited, nervous, scared, I'll light you up like a firework. High pain tolerance. And a dynamic duo of truly shitty bosses. I'll tell you the story, but I really need to find someone who can tune up my engine sooner rather than later. Believe me when I say this thing is hot. The first time I faced down those paladins, they let slip they'd met an infernal mechanic in the area. A tiefling. But I didn't see him anywhere. Sounds like a good lead. Hopefully our guy will be among them. A tune-up would do this old tub a world of good.
Who goes there? Ah, a friendly face. Oh, you are a sweet, sweet blessing, my dear. You know, I've had nothing but trouble all day. I've been accosted, chased, insulted. Look over there. Do you see that wretched little hive? Oh, it certainly looks that way. But inside, it is swarming with brutish, stupid, rude Githyanki. They have the audacity to call that hole a creche. As if it weren't actually a murderous training camp. Honestly, I was doing them a favor offering to buy one of their eggs. And how am I repaid? Attacked and run off like some transient. The Society of Brilliance asked me to acquire one of their roe so they can incubate it, and once it hatches, raise the spawn in their tradition. The society believes a Githyanki raised in a peaceful, nurturing environment can overcome its violent nature. Hogwash, of course. A Githyanki can no more rise above its nature than gnomes can fly. You've been sipping from the same goblet as the society. Perhaps you'd be willing to help them, to prove your point. They may have chased me away, but surely the Gith would welcome a person with such sympathetic views to their creche. And once inside, you could simply purloin an egg.
You'll be well compensated, of course. Just bring me an egg. I should hope so. When adventure calls, I am always thoroughly prepared. Take a look.
now. I believe you have places to be. I see this being a high... A word of advice. Avoid direct confrontation. Kresh-bound Githyanki can be a deadly sword.